Monday, September 14th. Revelations in Time Focus. The Gospels primarily center on Christ's first coming. They tell the story of His birth, His life and ministry, and His death and resurrection. Although they speak of His second coming, that is not their main emphasis. The book of Revelation's primary focus, however, is the climax of the centuries-long conflict of the ages. Each of its major prophecies ends in the glorious return of our Lord. Read Revelation 1:7, Revelation 11:15, Revelation 14:14-20, and Revelation 19:11-18. What similar conclusion do you see in each of these passages? Revelation 1:7. Behold, He is coming with clouds, and every eye will see Him, even they who pierced Him. And all the tribes of the earth will mourn because of Him. Even so, Amen. Revelation 11:15. Then the seventh angel sounded, and there were loud voices in heaven, saying, The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of His Christ, and He shall reign forever and ever. Revelation 14:14-20. 14 Then I looked, and behold, a white cloud, and on the cloud sat one like the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown, and in his hand a sharp sickle. 15 And another angel came out of the temple, crying with a loud voice to him who sat on the cloud, Thrust in your sickle and reap, for the time has come for you to reap, for the harvest of the earth is ripe. 16 So he who sat on the cloud thrust in his sickle on the earth, and the earth was reaped, reaping the grapes of wrath. 17 Then another angel came out of the temple which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. 18 And another angel came out from the altar, who had power over fire, and he cried with a loud cry to him who had the sharp sickle, saying, Thrust in your sharp sickle and gather the clusters of the vine of the earth, for her grapes are fully ripe. 19 So the angel thrust his sickle into the earth and gathered the vine of the earth, and threw it into the great winepress of the wrath of God. 20 And the winepress was trampled outside the city, and blood came out of the winepress, up to the horses' bridles, for 1,600 furlongs. Revelation 19:11-18. 11 Now I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he who sat on him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and makes war. 12 His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. 13 He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. 14 And the armies in heaven, clothed in fine linen, white and clean, followed him on white horses. 15 Now out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, that with it he should strike the nations. And he himself will rule them with a rod of iron. He himself treads the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. 16 And he has on his robe and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. 17 Then I saw an angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a loud voice, saying to all the birds that fly in the midst of heaven, Come and gather together for the supper of the great God. 18 That you may eat the flesh of kings, the flesh of captains, the flesh of mighty men, the flesh of horses and of those who sit on them, and the flesh of all people, free and slave, both small and great. From the first to the last chapter of the book of Revelation, the climax of each prophecy is the coming of Jesus. The Lamb who was slain, Revelation 5:12, in KJV, is coming again as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Revelation 19:16. He will defeat all of the foes that oppress and persecute His people, Revelation 17:14. He will deliver them from this nightmare of sin and bring them home to glory. The great controversy between good and evil will be ended. The earth will be made new, and the redeemed will live with their Lord forever, Revelation 21:1-4. In Revelation 22:7, see also Revelation 22:12, 17, 20, Jesus says, Behold, I am coming quickly. Blessed is he who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book, in KJV. Thus, Jesus' final appeal to all humanity is to respond to His love, accept His grace, and follow His truth to be ready for His soon return. Revelation concludes with Jesus' invitation, and the Spirit and the Bride say, Come. And let him who hears say, Come. Revelation 22:17, in KJV. Our Lord invites all of those who seek for eternal life to come to Him. He then invites those of us who have accepted the message of salvation and are eagerly anticipating His return to join Him and inviting others to accept the message of His love. He sends us out on His mission to share His message to prepare a world for His soon return. There is nothing more rewarding than participating with Jesus in His mission to the world. There is nothing more fulfilling than cooperating with Christ in His last day plan of salvation. Christ, coming quickly? John wrote those words about 2,000 years ago. However, given our understanding of the state of the dead, why is Christ's second coming never more than an instant after our death? How does this fact help us to understand how quickly, indeed, Christ is coming? By Adult Sabbath School Guide.